Effects of visual impairment on personality development, verbalism, and mannerism. As we know, physical activity has always been included in the education system of the sighted children. Now it becomes mandatory that every school must include some form of physical education as part of their curriculum. The benefit of physical activity is numerous and it can never be overemphasized. It aids in reducing the heart diseases, keeps the cholesterol levels in check, and controls the blood glucose levels too. Apart from such benefits, physical activity also helps in good psychological balance and generates good sleep. Also, when such activity is taken up outdoors, it further creates a good feeling, thereby improving the stamina levels of the children. Today, since children also undergo lot of stress due to their studies and peer, physical activity is a great stress buster. But unfortunately, the visually impaired children never get an opportunity to get involved in such physical activity due to their loss of vision. As such, they are not able to gain the benefits associated with the physical activity, which leads to lack of balanced psychological and social state of the mind. But their lack of getting such physical activity is not due to their visual disability, but it is because of the lack of encouragement and early intervention to get them into physical activities. The studies have revealed that visually impaired children exhibit higher levels of energy than their sighted peers. This is because the daily routine work that is done by sighted child is done by the visually impaired by burning out more energy. Thus, it is a proof that the visually impaired also can participate in the physical activities. Now, there are several barriers for the non-inclusion of physical activities for the blind. This in turn affects their mental health also. The following gives a deeper awareness about the various barriers and their associated issues. Also, the communication barriers can be overcome by the proper implementation of the various devices and other techniques. This helps in better social interaction of the blind and also in a way makes them all the more independent. Teachers are considered as a friend, philosopher, and a guide for a visually impaired child, while the emotional support is granted by the family. It is the teacher who opens the world of knowledge to the child with visually disabled. The intellectual and social arena requires a lot of intervention by the teacher at the right time in order to mold the life of the visually impaired in the right manner. But when it comes to physical education to visually impaired, many teachers are still in the stage of aversion. The following are the reasons attributable for such an attitude of the teacher. First, absence of professional preparation. The major barrier is the lack of information provided to the teacher during their training stage. Not many teachers are aware of the visual impairment and its effects. Also, the need for physical education to even the visually impaired children is never emphasized during the training of the teachers. Teachers must be trained to understand the effects of blindness and inculcate creative techniques to formulate games and other physical activities that are apt for the blind children. Recreational activities and fitness activities must be taught to include both the sighted and the blind children. When awareness is created amongst the teacher, it also helps in bringing out newer ideas of physical activities that will suit the blind also. Second, restriction of curriculum. Many of the physical activities or games like basketball, football, badminton and so on requires the visual as well as motor skill coordination. This may be very difficult for the blind and they require the assistance of their sighted peers in such activities. But with some modifications, such physical games can be made to suit the requirements of the visually impaired children too. Instead of the normal balls, teachers can make use of auditory balls or balls that is slow moving. They can also change the rule of the game to make it much more convenient to the child with visual disability. Activities like swimming, aerobics, wrestling, gymnastics, and even martial arts are some other forms of physical activities that do not require support of others. This also provides greater independence to the child. Third, speed of the learning process. Quite often, the teachers are under the impression that the visual impaired child can learn at the same pace as that of the sighted peers. But this is not true. The visually impaired child requires more time and extra individual attention to understand the concept of physical activity to be performed. The teacher must be aware of this point and so devote greater time to make the child with visual disability to understand the concept of the game. Only after this, the activity must be started in unison. Student-centric teaching approach is proven to be much more beneficial than the teacher-directed way of teaching for the visually impaired. Fourth, overprotection. Due to the inability to see and visualize the environment, the teachers may fear that involvement of the visually impaired in physical activities may cause dangerous hazards. They may fear that accidents may happen to the child as well as the people around the child. As a result, the teacher does not encourage the child to participate in such physical activities. This can be overcome by proper training to the teacher to get the confidence about the visually impaired children. Fifth, restricted expectation. Teachers are under the wrong impression that the visually impaired lack in potential. They never try to find out the hidden potential of the visually impaired children. Many of the blind children can outperform their sighted peers even in physical activities as their auditory and tactical clues are much stronger. The teachers must be trained to understand the potential of the blind and unearth them through proper encouragement. Physical activities need to be analyzed in detail to understand the modifications required to make it suitable for the blind. With proper interventions and encouragement, the visually impaired child will be able to perform well in physical activities. Sixth, students' barriers. Now, having understood the barriers imposed by the teacher, it is equally important to know the barriers of the students also. Many visually impaired students have a negative attitude toward physical education. They have a feeling that they can never involve in any kind of physical activity. But most of such barriers are in a way imposed by the individual or due to their lack of information about the opportunities of physical education. Overprotective parents. It is a significant point in the development of the visually impaired children. Many parents try to discourage their children from physical education due to their insecure feeling. It is inevitable because parents tend to develop a special interest in their child's safety, and this is higher in case of visually impaired children. But by being so overprotective, they are actually hindering the growth potentials of the child. Many visually impaired children may have the potential for any physical activity, but they may need to be that extra push from their parents and teachers to bring it out. The motor skills of the child with visual disability may be low, but through practice and training, it can be improved to suit the requirements of the physical activity. Eighth, absence of opportunities. Opportunities must be made available at the right time. Only then they can tap the hidden potential of the children. In case of the blind children, many of their early skill development is hindered due to their family's insecurity and lack of encouragement. Many of the skills for the physical activity have to be developed right from the early stages of the life of the visually impaired. Only if this is done, can they go on to become an expert in any form of physical activity like swimming, gymnastics, etc. Control techniques need to be taught to the children with visually disabled, and also the motor skills needs to be developed at a very early age. The inhibition that the blind child will not be able to perform physical tasks has to be removed first completely from the mind of the children, as well as the parents and the teachers. Ninth, lack of confidence. The confidence levels are directly related to the level of opportunities. The visually impaired children lack in confidence due to the absence of opportunities that is given to them. Also, the visually impaired children are often scared of the games due to their fear of losing it. They also have a fear of getting hurt, and as a result, try to avoid participating in physical activities. To overcome such issues, the visually impaired children must be encouraged during their early growth stages to go out and involve in several physical activities like jumping, running, skipping, and walking. The local parks can be a great place to take the children so that they also find a pathway that will aid in their walking without hindrance. It is only through continuous efforts on the part of the individual that they can participate in physical activities. The 10th barrier, administrative barriers. Apart from the barriers imposed by the visually impaired and the teachers, there are also other administrative barriers that cause hindrance for involving the visually impaired in the physical education. 11th one, time. Time at times becomes a major constraint, as many of the visually impaired children delay in reaching their milestone. This also means that they take time to get hold of the level of knowledge as that of their sighted peers. Quite often, the entire day of the visually impaired children will be spent in Braille classes and training for mobility and also occupational therapy. Such classes consume most of the time of the child with visual disability, that they are left with little time to involve in any other physical education. This is not the right kind of attitude. Sighted children also have a very stringent schedule with their studies and other extracurricular activities, but still they are advised to involve in the physical education. And it has become mandatory to include it in the school curriculum also. So the same applies even to the visually impaired children of the same age. No vocational therapy or other classes can replace the physical education. The benefits provided by the physical games and other activities cannot be provided by any other activity. Every child with visual disability must be forced to involve in the physical education of their choice, and proper timetable must be set for the same. 12th, no equipment for the blind. Yet another barrier that requires the support of the government is the lack of equipment to suit the special needs of the visually impaired children involving in physical education. Many schools have a restricted budget, and often the equipment for visually impaired children tend to be very high. Auditory balls or balls with beeper and larger balls, etc., may be required to involve the participation of the visually impaired. As said, the modification required in the regular game in order to make it suitable for the visually impaired requires the investment of money, and this may not be easy for school with low budget. The government can play a major role by providing funds for such equipments. Also, many of the foreign countries provide advanced equipment by taking into consideration the various perspectives of the visually impaired to invent newer devices for physical education. Such instruments can be made available for the visually impaired to encourage and make physical education all the more interesting. Medical reasons. Many of the doctors are ready to give fake medical certificates on the request of the child's parents or even the teachers. Parents' fear of accidents and also the teachers' incapability to involve visually impaired in physical education, which may lead them to get a medical certificate, stating that the child is not fit to take part in physical education. But such fake medical reasons actually cause hindrance in the normal development of the child. The visually impaired child is not able to experience all the joys of life that his sighted peers do. Also, the child with visual disability is losing all the health benefits that are related to the physical education. The stress levels will be reduced and the confidence boosts up when an individual involves in physical education. The parents must encourage with an open mind their child to participate in the physical education activities. Now, communication with the visually impaired is very difficult, and that is the reason many people do not interact with the blind. Even the person with visual disability is often embarrassed in the social environment, as people around him do not talk in a normal tone. The following methods can help the visually impaired in overcoming this awkward situation and also foster their social interaction. It is essential to consider the fact that visually impaired people deserve the maximum respect and integrity. So, facilities to overcome their difficulties due to visual disability must be provided at all public places. This will help the blind to come out of the house and get free mobility. Also, this helps in communicating easily with the blind and they will be happy to interact in the social sphere. Facilities can be auditory clues, braille formats of all the activities of a place and many more. It also includes appointing of a person to read out aloud for the visually impaired people anything that they require. Not most of the blind are ready to accept their visual disability instantly. Many try to avoid this in order to avoid being showered with pity and sympathy. They have high self-esteem and such actions are not going to help them, but they are sure to feel dejected. So when we see a blind person, the best way to help them would be to ask them courteously. Ask them their requirement in a friendly tone and never be sympathetic. Be natural in the conversation and try to avoid questions related to their disability. This way, the blind person will also be encouraged to talk freely and ask for any kind of assistance. Some people may not have a complete loss of vision. They could see partially, but still are coming under the category of visually impaired. As a result, the information must be displayed in larger fonts, so that even the visually impaired people can read it without any difficulties. Make it all the more brighter so that they do not cause strain to the eyes of the visually impaired. Some people may be blind, and for such people, other forms like braille information leaflet can be handed over so that they get an idea about the place and its surroundings. When a visually impaired person asks for direction, it is essential to give even the minute detail. Sighted people often give direction vaguely, which may cause confusion in the minds for the visually impaired. Landmark that can be easily identified by the blind must be included as far as possible in the directions. Give clear instructions such that the visually impaired will be able to reach the place of his desire without any kind of hindrance. There are many vision aid devices that can be kept handy in shops and other public places to help the visually impaired people. Items like magnifiers, blood pressure meters, those talks, elevator button with audible sounds, elevators that calls out the floor number, talking scales, and so on. Understand the importance of each of these devices and try to accessorize the office such that even the visually impaired can easily glide through the office with no difficulty. Regular print modes as well as Braille system must be employed as far as possible. In offices, departments, and shops, this aids in easy verification for the blind. Forms, if required to be filled, must also be provided in Braille system, which again makes the blind able to fill it independently. In this unit, we have covered the barriers imposed by the HR and the visually impaired and the ways of overcoming the same and participating in the physical education. Also, we have seen the importance and benefits of physical education, which is enumerated, and it is understood that physically fit body only can nurture a fit mind. It also gives a deep understanding about the communication methodologies that can be inculcated in order to effectively communicate with the visually impaired children. Vision is a major communication organ, and many of the sighted children learn and speak through their vision. But lack of this does not make the children completely isolated. The various communication methods help in better social interaction and also develop verbalism of the blind children. Visually impaired children can be of different types depending upon their level of loss of vision. However, most of them communicate in different forms like expressive languages and auditory clues and so on. This unit will help the HR trainee in involving better modes of communication with the blind.